हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पार्ट टू स्टार्टिंग विथ काली लिनक्स। वी आर गोइंग टू कवर कॉन्फ़िगरिंग नेटवर्क सर्विसेज, स्टार्टिंग एंड स्टॉपिंग रिक्वायर्ड सर्विसेज, रीसेटिंग द रूट पासवर्ड एंड एडिंग नॉन रूट यूज़र एंड इंस्टॉलिंग बूटअप मैनेजर एंड स्पीडिंग अप काली लिनक्स ऑपरेशन। इन दिस सेशन so we are starting with configuring network services. The first step is being able to use Kali is to ensure that it has connectivity to either a wireless or a wired network to support updates and customization. You may need to obtain an IP addresses by DHCP or assigned statically. We are using with NAT adapter in VMware, so it will give automatically GET from DHCP. Suppose we need to configure statically, then you need to perform below command in terminal. First of all, we need to check IP address using ifconfig command. So we just check IP address using ifconfig command, and you can see here it's our IP address. In this particular case, the VM has been assigned an IP addresses. If an IP address was not obtained, the address can be assigned by DHCP using the DH client command. So if we need to renew our IP address from DHCP, then we need to perform DH client and our interface name 80H0. If static IP address is used, we need additional information may be required. Suppose we need to set IP address to 192.168.10.10 and give gateway to 192.168.10.1. In that case, we perform following command: ifconfig our interface name, IP address and subnet mask, and we need also add default gateway by typing following command: add default gateway and our gateway IP address. So we are assigned manually ifconfig eth0 192.168.10.10 netmask 255.255.255.0. Now add default gateway, so route add default gateway and 192.168.10.1, and we check IP address using ifconfig command, and you can see here change made to IP setting are non-persistent and it will be lost when Kali is rebooted. To make the change permanent, you will need to edit etc network and interface file. So we are going to assign IP statically. We are use vi editor etc network and interface file and press I key to insert mode, and we need to change here DHCP to static. Now address to 192.168.10.10, net mask 255.255.255.0, network to 192.168.10.0, broadcast to 192.168.10.255, gateway to 192.168.10.1, and if you have DNS server, then you can assign DNS by DNS-name server and assign your IP address here. None for me, so I just mark that and press escape colon and write quiet and exit to change that file. Restart your network service, so service networking restart, and it will restart your network services. By this way you can assign your static IP address. By default, Kali does not start with the DHCP services enabled. This may not be an issue, and it may be advantageous to have certain services start automatically during boot up. This can be achieved by entering the following command: update-rc.d networking and defaults restart network services from etc init.d networking restart. Now check IP address ifconfig command, and you can see here our eth0 interface is disable, so we need to enable that. So if up eth0 and check again our IP, and you can see here. Now next is starting and stopping required services. Kali install with network services that can be started or stopped as required, including DHCP, HTTP, SSH, TFTP and the VNC server. These services are usually invoked from the command line, however some are accessible from the Kali menu. I just show you application, Kali Linux and system services. You can start and stop necessary services from here. Suppose we need to start, stop or restart the SSH service, then we run following command: service SSH start, and it will start our SSH service. Then another command: service SSH restart, and it will restarting our SSH service. And another command: service SSH stop, to stop that services. You can do same for other services like DHCP, HTTP, TFTP and VNC. Next is resetting root password and adding non-root users. To change a user password, you use following command: password and your root username. So password and root, type your password here twice and you can see the password update successfully. Many of the application provided in Kali must run with root level privileges in order to function. Root level privileges do possess a certain amount of risk. For example, misking a command or using a wrong command can cause application to fail over or even damage the system being tested. So we need to create non-root user. You can simply use the command called add user from the terminal and follow the instruction that appear. So add user called new, enter username password twice, full name, another field leave it default, and type y and press enter. It will create our new user called new. We can check using go to application, system tools, preferences and system settings and user accounts. You can see here new standard user created. Next is installing bootup manager and speeding up Kali operations. Several tools can be used to optimize and speed up Kali operations. If you are using VMware or VirtualBox, you need to install VMware tool or guest edition respectively. The preload application identifies a user's most commonly used program and preload binaries and dependencies into the memory to provide faster access. It works automatically after the first restart. So we are going to install preload application. apt-get install preload, and it will install preload application to our Kali Linux. Next is bleach bit, free disk space and improve privacy by feeding the cache, deleting cookies, clearing internet history, shedding temporary file, deleting logs and discarding other unnecessary file. So we are going to install bleach bit. So apt-get install bleach bit. You can run bleach bit by typing bleach bit in terminal, and you can see here graphic window. You can clear different type of histories, temporary file from here. By default, Kali does not show all application there are present in startup menu, including boot up manager. Install boot up manager to unnecessary services and applications that are enabled during the boot up. So we need to install boot up manager. Apt-get install BUM. And we can access through just typing BUM and it will load GUI version. We can active and inactive any services from here. It's depend on your use. So that's all about starting with Kali Linux. Please subscribe and give your feedback. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you so much.